What is up, guys? Ashbfc here, and welcome to Dino Crisis, one of my favourite PlayStation games from my childhood. Well, this and its sequel, Dino Crisis 2. Absolutely love them. There was a third Dino Crisis on Xbox, but we don't talk about that game. Yeah, as far as I'm concerned, there never was a third game. There's just two of them. But yeah, absolutely love them both. So, I know I've said this before, probably more than once, but I'm going to say it again. Where the hell are all the goddamn dinosaur games these days? Where have they gone? Seriously, this series needs to come back, and just dinosaur games in general need to come back. It ain't right. But anyway, for those who don't know anything about this series, never played it, never heard of it, whatever, this game is it's a survival horror game. It was created by the original Resident Evil team. It was directed by the creator of Resident Evil, the legendary Shinji Mikami, and it is old school Resident Evil, but take out the zombies and stuff and just slap in dinosaurs. That's what you've got. I think Capcom used to advertise it as Survival Panic. But yeah, that's pretty much what it is. The sequel, Dino Crisis 2, was more of an action game. But yeah, this one was survival horror, and it's awesome. They both are. But anyway, come on, let's not delay. Let's start this crisis. Here we go. Dino Crisis. Let's do it. Normal.
You have mail. The second report from Military Experiment Facility. Agent name, Tom.
I have successfully infiltrated under the guise of a researcher as planned. I have encountered no information regarding top secret development of new type weapons. But I have discovered there is an unexpected individual at this facility. The man is Dr. Kirk, the leading authority of our nation's energy research. Dr. Kirk was alleged to have died in an accident during the course of an experiment 3 years ago. The reports were premature, and it appears that he is currently working as the head of a non-weapon project at this facility. The experiment is in the late stages of development. Regarding the staged accidental death, it appears that this country is somehow involved, recommending that necessary actions be taken immediately.
Refer to the data on Dr. Kirk. Operation instructions.
I'm late.
It's time. Let's move out.
What about Cooper?
Forget him. Time's up.
Wait!
Thank you.
Okay. This is the first checkpoint. Playtime is officially over, kiddies.
Something's wrong. The lights in the guardhouse are out.
Maybe this has been a wild night of partying for the guards. You know, a little song, a little dance.
Stay here, Junior. Leave the guards to me.
Hey, did you hear what he just called me?
Forget about it. Just let Gale handle this.
All right. It's clear.
What's going on with that dude's hair? Seriously.
Okay, let's do this. I'll infiltrate the facility and... I should have access to all the security systems from there. I'll contact you as soon as I've cleared the room.
Looks like he's got a dead raccoon on his head. Anyway, you might have noticed that, you know, some of his speech got cut off. I'm emulating the game on PlayStation, and that seems to be an issue. I can't seem to fix it. So, I'm sorry about that. It doesn't seem to be too much of an issue. For the most part, the speech is fine, but...
Let me guess. This is some of your handiwork, right?
The brass is still warm. These guards were shooting at something very recently.
So who were they fighting?
This wasn't much of a fight. I don't think these guards hit anything before getting sliced and diced. Whatever they were shooting at came in through there. Ripped right through the steel fence.
Well, the hole is nice and clean. But I still say you could have done this.
Very funny. We still need to figure out what happened here. Continue to sweep the area.
I can tell you what did that. It was a freaking dinosaur! They don't know that, do they? But yeah, as I was saying, the speech, it seems to be a bit of an issue, but hopefully it's not too bad. I didn't want to capture it directly from the PlayStation, because it looked like crap. I can't get the PC version running on Windows 7. And there is a Dreamcast version, which actually looks better and it runs at 60 frames per second, but I'm having saving issues with that on the emulator. So I'm kind of just the best I could do, so I am sorry for the speech problem. But here we go, push this, we've got a med pack. Yeah, that's just, think of it as like a green herb from Resident Evil or any other health item you'd see in a game. You also got Hermstat as well, that stops you from bleeding. I'm pretty sure dinosaurs can smell your blood. If I remember right, so don't need to worry about that for right now. Anyway, you need the B1 backup, so we can't get in there. Alright, there is an item in there, we can't get to it yet. So let's have a look in here. Material storage. Yeah, this is Regina we're playing as right now. She's also in the sequel. We've got the BG area key, okay? And actually, we could push this shelf. There we go, it's another item on top of there. Let's go ahead and grab that. Resuscitation, okay. Right, yeah. That can, that revives you if you've been killed. So that can be a very useful item right there. Hopefully I won't need one. But knowing me, I probably will. Okay, right. Now, yeah, we can't go in there. We'll try going down here where that other guy went. With raccoon on his head.
Rick can handle the inside of the facility on his own.
Boss giving his orders. Okay, boss. Right, well, we can only go this way. Cool.
Rick here. I'm in. The place is deserted, though. I have a very bad feeling about this.
How's the progress going with that security system?
I don't know what's been going on here, but it looks like all the power in this facility's been cut.
Same here.
As long as that's the situation, there's not a lot I can do. Why don't you see if you can gain access to the backup generators on the ground level?
I'm on it. What are you doing here?
I caught the last part of your conversation.
By the way, I found a key.
Hand it over. Let's head outside.
Hey! That was my key! He's an asshole, isn't he? The backyard. Yeah, it uses the same sort of door opening as well as Resident Evil, apart from you can actually see your character, and it's a little bit faster. To To be honest, I'm not sure which I prefer, this or Dino Crisis 2. I mean, I'm tempted to say this one because of my love for survival horror, but, you know, the second one's still a damn good game. Passageway to the backup generator. Okay, I'm gonna get the power on. And I was always fascinated with dinosaurs when I was a kid. Thanks to Jurassic Park. God, I love that film. Oh, it scared me, though, give me nightmares. I mean, come on, I was about 6 years old. I used to always dream there was a T-Rex outside my window, and that raptors got in my house. But hang on a minute. Oh god.
That's disgusting.
This guy's been eviscerated. Something tore his intestines.
Look at those tooth marks. It had to be some sort of animal.
Okay, let's move on.
I don't think it was a pack of wild boars, that's for sure. I love her response. There's a corpse in half mutilated, and she's just like, that's disgusting. Not like, oh my god, what the hell? Man. Regina. She's tough. What's he doing?
I'll stand guard here. You go inside and take a look around.
Okay, fair enough. In fact, there's a new Jurassic Park film coming out anyway. It's not Jurassic Park, it's Jurassic World, isn't it, next year? I'm looking forward to it. I'm slightly nervous that they're going to mess it up. I don't know much about it. I know Chris Pratt's lead, isn't he? And I don't know if it's a sequel or if it's a reboot or whatever, but... Here we go, first puzzle. Incredibly easy one. There are three buttons. Which button will you press? Right, well, actually, we go on cancel. We've got like four of those little coil plug things there. Right, you know these levers, they say, these, well, they've got colours on them. We've got red, blue, green, and white, and that's the order we've got to get these ones in. So, you can see the red. The red's there, so that's fine. We've got to get the blue one next to that. So I press the rightmost switch, flip that around there. And then press the centre one. Right, and then this one again to get the green there. Yeah, there we go. Red, blue, green, white. Alright, cancel. Now we hit these. Give it a pull. There we go. Super easy. Alright, power's on. Let's get out of here. Uh-oh. That didn't sound good.
Gail?
Yeah, didn't do the heartbeat thing like Resident Evil would have done. Looks like Gail's gone. Oh god, blood. Lots of blood noise. Uh-oh. Big ass hole in the fence. This ain't looking good.
Gail!
Oh god. Here we go. Oh, run! Okay, don't stay fighting, run! This way! Okay, what problem? The raptor's quicker than you, but he can't turn as quick as you, so you're gonna use that to your advantage. Ah! See, if you sort of zigzag, it throws him off. Ah! He's not too hard to avoid as long as you sort of don't walk in a straight line, otherwise he's gonna get you. Yeah, different story to the zombies. They can just hop over. Let's go through here. Gone for now.
Good news! I got the control system back online. What's the situation over there?
It's Gail. I lost him.
So what's the bad news? Did you run into some guards?
You're not gonna believe this. He was attacked by some kind of dinosaur.
Now that's a good one. So, who was it? Ernie?
This isn't a joke, you idiot. We were just attacked by a big-ass lizard.
For real? What's going on over there? All right. Head over to the control room and we'll sort out this whole situation.
Okay, he don't believe us. You know, I recognize the voice actor for Regina. I've heard it before. I think she must have done some other video games. Definitely sounds familiar. In fact, doesn't that sound a little bit like Jill from Resident Evil 3? Or is that just me? Anyway. Right. We're going this way. Yeah, raptors, they're going to be the biggest pain in the arse. They're the most common enemy. There's actually only four different types of dinosaurs. We've got raptors, which obviously they're fast. We've got, I think it's called like a Therizinosaurus or something like that. It's like a bulkier raptor. They're a serious threat. We'll see those later. There's those little compies. There's one that's like a pterodactyl, but it's not a pterodactyl. I forgot what it's called, but it flies. And of course, there's the big bad T-Rex. Anyway, we'll meet them all in due time. Well, I heard one, but I don't see one. There's a ventilation opening. I believe that I could reach it by climbing. Well, unless you can fly, it's the only way you're going to reach it. No, not quite yet. Okay, we've got the laser fence here. We can't do what about that now, but they'll come into play a bit later. They can be, you don't want to walk into them because they hurt you. I'm going to show you. Oh, yeah. But also, they hurt dinosaurs as well, so you can use them to your advantage. But we don't need to worry about them for now. So, it's a notice he's posted. 10 a.m., Dr. Kurt's lecture. The future of the stabilizer. Don't know what that is, but, okay, that's locked, so we can really only go up the ventilation shaft. Ooh, look, she got a little grappling hook. Whee! Alright, we're in the vents. And we're going to want to go down this first opening right here. Here we go. Ah! Which you're going to use again to get down. Could just jump. Oh, here we go. Funky music. Sounds like danger's nearby. Oh, what we got here? Will you take the 9mm? Yes, I will. It's just ammo. Of course, survival horror, you got to be careful. In fact, it's often best to run from the dinosaurs rather than fight them, because they're a little bit more of a threat than just a slow-moving zombie from Resident Evil. But here we go, we got one of these emergency boxes. These are kind of annoying. You can store medical supplies in there, but you've got to use plugs to open them, which you can find, so you can't just freely access them. So, yeah, they can be a bit of a pain in the arse. Okay, well, we ain't going that way. Shut us down. So, let's head into the control room. And laugh at this guy's haircut.
What's our status?
This security system is a snap for me. Real amateur stuff. So what exactly happened to Gale? You said that he was attacked by a
Yeah. I couldn't believe it. I just hope he's still alive. Anyway, our first priority is to complete the mission.
What we ought to do is just call in the chopper and get off this death trap.
That's a great idea, but Cooper has the radio, and he's missing. Hey, what's with this monitor?
That's the security monitor for the underground area. The camera's offline.
So I take it that means power still hasn't been restored to the area.
Exactly. They must have that area wired to a different power system than the ground level.
We can investigate that area after we've finished our sweep of the ground level.
Okay, then I'll take care of the shutters that are blocking the way. You work your way in, grab the dock, and then rendezvous back here.
Yeah, well, the speech needs to be stuttering there, so I'm going to see if I can fix it. I'll try and get the Dreamcast version working or something, because it's going to be really annoying, isn't it? But, yeah, I'll end this one here, and, well, next time, see if we can figure out what the hell is dinosaurs do on this island. They went extinct millions of years ago. What the hell's going on? Some Jurassic Park shit going down? Anyway, guys, as usual, thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time.